गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द डिक्शनरीज इन पाइथन। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडी अबाउट द लिस्ट, सो टुडे वी विल लर्न व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द पाइथन लिस्ट एंड पाइथन डिक्शनरी। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय कलेक्शंस? कलेक्शन मीन्स व्हाट? सर्टेन थिंग्स दैट वी विल पुट टुगेदर। यू know that in the list it is just as like array, that means all the values that we have to store into the list, we cannot identify that values by the key, we can identify the particular list item by the index value. So we can see that the Python list is just like a array, but dictionary means what? We can put more than one value and we can carry all them into the one package. Simple example, my bag, your pocket. Pocket can contain the many things. Okay, suppose your bag also contains pen, pencil, books, notebooks. Okay, so it contains more than one items, but every item that is having a different key values. So we can see that the bunch of the values that we have to put into the single variable, we can do it that by using the Python list. Another thing, it is also possible that we are finding out the particular item by its key value into the dictionary, but it is not possible with the list. Suppose most of our variables, they are having the same data type, and whenever any values or any variable that is declared with the one values, and if we are giving the another value to the variable, then what is happening? That the variable is overwritten with the new value. That means old value is erased, or the new values that is overwritten in that variable. Here you can see that here I am giving the one variable x equal to 2, x equal to 4. But whenever I am assigning the new values, then it is overwritten 4 into the 2. So here you can see that the output, that is 4. So that is not into the collections. So what is the story of the two collections? Here you can see that list means what? Collection of the values that is stay in a order. That's why we are accessing all the elements in the list by using the index. But in the dictionary, the bunch of values, many items and every items that we can finding out by the key, and every key that is having its own values and that is given with its own label. So the most important difference between the list and the dictionary is there. In the list we are finding out with the index value, while in the dictionary that we will find out by using the key value. Here you can see that I am giving the examples of the bag. Like in the bag, calculator is there, tissue paper is there, money is there, candy is there, perfume is there, pen pencil is there, eraser is there, notebook is there. So many values, they are having the different items that we have to put it together, that is known as dictionaries. So the dictionary, we can see that it is a powerful data collection in the Python. We can access the data from the database, and that we have to store into the dictionaries, and we are doing the many database operations like crude operations, create, read, update and delete operations into the Python. Okay, so we can see that the dictionaries, they are having the different names. Now here you can see that how to create the dictionaries into the Python. Here you can see that in the Python, if we want to declare the dictionaries, how can we do it? We can do it by first of all giving the variable name as a dictionary. Okay, dictionary means they are not having the particular order. Okay, so we can access the particular items by its key value. Here you can see that I am declaring the one variable as a dictionary. Now how to declare the dictionaries? Variable name equal to dict, that is for the dictionary, and we are giving the brackets. Now here I am declaring the variable pers, but that is not having any values. Now in the previous example we can say that in a bag money is there, candy is there, tissue paper is there. So suppose in my bag money is 12, so what I am giving here, purse money equal to 12, purse candy equal to 3, purse tissue equal to 75. So this is the my index value, that we can say that. And if we want to fetch the values, we are not using the index, we are using the money, candy and tissues as a key values. So if I want to print the values of candy, how can I do it? Otherwise we can print all the elements of the dictionary by using the print functions. So that's why here I am giving the print pers. Here you can see that print pers. If I want to find out only the values of the candies, that is given by candy. Now if I want to access the particular elements, I am giving the particular key values, that is giving here. If I want to make the changes in that key values, how can we do it? We can access that elements and we are doing the whatever is the operations that we want to do, that we can do it. Suppose if I want to increase the value of the candy, then how can I do it? Purse candy equal to purse candy plus 2. So here I am increase the value of the candy. So here you can see that the value of candy, that is equal to 3 here, but now it will become the 5. So in this way we can declare the dictionary, access the data elements, and we are doing the update the operations. Now here we are comparing the list and the dictionaries. What is the dictionaries? Dictionaries, we can see that they are using the keys instead of the index value if we want to look up the values. Here you can see that in left hand side the list is there, right hand side dictionary is there. If we want to declare the list, list can be also declared by using the square brackets. It can be, that is what depends on the Python versions. Whatever is the versions that you are using, according to that we are giving the brackets. Right hand side, if we want to declare the dictionary, how can I do? We can do it with the variable name equal to dictionary. Here you can see that if I want to add the elements into the list, one by one we can append the elements. Here you can see that I am appending the two variables, 21, 183. So it can be printed by using the index value, LSD of 0 equal to this, LSD of 1 equal to this, so that we can get the elements of the list. If we want to change the values of the list, we can give it. Here you can see that by giving the index values. But in the dictionary, if I want to store, we can store the with the key values. Here I am giving age is equal to 21, course is equal to 182. If I want to print that, then print the values by using the key values. Okay, so if we are using the particular key values, then we can do it by get values. Now, what is the dictionary literals and the constants? Means dictionary literals are used curly brackets, and what is the syntax for that? If you want to store the values like the key and that is having the particular value pair, then how can we given it? Whenever we are declaring the dictionaries, we can give it. Here you can see that I have a empty dictionary triple J. So triple J is equal to, now you can see that here I am giving the three values: Chuck 1, Fred 42, and Jan 100. Now if I want to print the values, how can we print it? By the print and the dictionary name. Okay, if we want to print the dictionary as a null or empty, we can also give it by simply giving the empty brackets, so it will be declared as a empty dictionaries. Now dictionary that is also having some properties, so we will see the properties and the functions that is associated with the dictionary. Now here we can see that how to update the directories. We can update the directories by the particular key value and whatever is the value that we want to update, that we can do it by that. Now how to delete the dictionary elements? Now if we want to remove the individual dictionary elements, we can also do it. And if we want to clear all the contents of the dictionary, we can also delete the entire collections into the single operations. So how can we do it? Here you can see that I am having one dictionary. The value is first, that is name is equal to Zara, age is equal to 7, and class equal to first. Now if I want to remove the entry, all the entries, okay, from the dictionaries, then what is the functions that I am using? So for that I am using the clear. Okay, so what is the thing is that dict dot clear, that remove all the entries into the directories. If we want to delete the entire dictionaries, then how can we do it? We can do it by the del and then dict, that means it will delete the entire directory. So this will produce the results that the entire dictionary is, means the clear will remove only entries, the structure of the dictionary is still exist. But if we are using the del directory, then what happens? It will delete the entries also, it will also delete the structures also. So by using these clear, we can remove all the entries. Okay, and if we want to remove the particular entry, suppose here I want to remove the name from the dictionary, how can I give it? We can give it by using del dict, and in the brackets we are giving the key values that we want to remove from the list. Here I am giving name, then the name Zara, that particular entry is removed from the dictionaries. Next, what are the properties of the dictionaries? Now the dictionary values that has no restrictions. That means we can also give the user defined objects, we can also give the values true and false. So what are the first two properties of the dictionary? More than one entry per key is not allowed into the dictionary. That means no duplicate key is allowed. Okay, suppose I am giving name Zara. Here you can see that if we are giving the two key values, like here in the dictionary I am giving name is equal to Zara, age equal to 7, name is equal to Mani. That means two key values and they are having the repeated, and the one value is Zara, another is Mani. Then what will be the happens? It will be that whatever is the last assignment that is given. So name is equal to Zara, that is the first value. But whenever we are giving the name is equal to Mani, then it will be overwritten into the Zara. So here you can see that into the dictionary, whenever I am printing that value, the output is name is equal to Mani. So this is the first properties of the dictionary key. What is the second properties? The second properties, that is key must be immutable. That means you can use string, numbers or the tuples as a dictionary keys, but something like key is not allowed. Okay, here you can see that dictionary name is equal to Zara and age is equal to 7. So this will produce the following result, means an exception is raised. Why? Because of that only the key values that is given here. So any values that we read from the database that can be also given. That means keys must be immutable. It is not mutable. Now, what are the built-in dictionary functions and the methods available? So first of all, we will see what are the functions that is available into the dictionaries. Now, whenever we are using the functions, we are giving the function name and in the brackets we are giving the arguments. How can we do it? Here the first functions CMP, through which we are comparing the elements of the dictionaries. Suppose if I want to compare the two dictionaries, then what is the syntax? CMP is the function name and in the arguments I am giving the two dictionaries. So it will compare the elements of the both dictionary. Now if I want to find out the length of the dictionary, inbuilt alien functions that will find out the number of the items that is available into the dictionaries. Strdict, that means it will produce the printable string presentations of a dictionary. That means whatever is the values that you have to given, and if you want to convert it into the string presentations, then we can do it by using the str. Type variables means it returns the particular type of the pass variables. You can know that if I am giving the type, if it is a class, it will give the class. If it is an integer, it will give the integer. If the class is, if the type is float, then it will be written as the float. So in we are passing any variable, then in the dictionaries, then it will return the dictionary type. Also the methods that is available with the dictionary. Suppose if I want to, in the clear we can say that if we want to remove all the elements from the dictionary, we are using the clear methods. Now what are the methods? Method means whatever is the dictionary that I declare in my programs, and if I want to using the inbuilt methods, how can we use it? Dictionary variable that we declare dot and the method name. So first is the clear. If we remove all the elements of the dictionary, we are using clear. If we want to make the copy of the dictionaries, then what I will be give? I will be give as a dot copy. If I want to create the new dictionaries, with the key values by using the sequence, and if we want to set the values of that dictionary, we are using the from keys. Okay, next most important method, that is the get method. Whatever is the value that we are giving to the particular key, and if we want to fetch the elements of the keys, then we are using the dictionary get functions. So whatever is the key and whatever is the value that is given here, that we can fetch it. Another functions, that is the hash key, that means that whatever is the key that I am giving, and if we want to compare both of them, so that it will return true if the dictionary is containing that values. Dictionary items, that means if we want to use whatever is the dictionary's keys and values but into the tuple pairs, we are using the dot items. Same way, if I want the keys values, then how can we get it? We can get it by the dictionary's key. If we want to set the default values, then we can also do it by using the functions set default. So in the argument, what I am giving particular key and its default values. Dictionary dot update, if we want to add the particular key value pairs to the particular dictionary, means update from the another dictionary, then we can give it by using the update functions. And the another, that is the dictionary dot values, that means it returns the list of the dictionary values. So what we learned today, what is the difference between the Python list and the dictionary? List variables are accessed by using the index values, while the dictionary variables, they will be accessed by using the key values. What are the different operations that we can do with the dictionaries, that we will learn into the next lectures. But before that, we must know how to access the particular elements from the dictionaries and how to declare the variables into the dictionaries. Okay, so here we are go with the programs that is related with the dictionaries, so we can know that in the details. If we are giving the certain values into the dictionaries, we know that in the Python we are using the inbuilt functions and we can do it. Okay, in the next lectures we will learn all the programs that is related with the dictionary. If you are having any query, any problems, you can give me message through the classroom. You can also call me and you can also give your comments into the Google Classroom. So before go with the next lectures, all of you learn how to declare the dictionary, how to accessing values into the dictionaries, and in the next lecture we are using the different methods and the functions that is used with the Python dictionary.